Stanley and Zero slept off and on for the next 2 days, ate onions all they wanted, and splashed the dirty water into their mouth. In the late afternoon, Big Dumb gave them shade. Stanley tried to make the hole deeper, but he really needed the shovel. His efforts just seemed to stir up the mud and make the water dirtier. Zero was sleeping. He was still very sick and weak, but the sleep and the onion seemed to be doing him some good. Stanley was no longer afraid that he would die soon. Still, he didn't want to go for the shovel while Zero was asleep. He didn't want him to wake up and think he'd been deserted. He waited for Zero to open his eyes. "I think I'll go look for the shovel," Stanley said. "I'll wait here," Zero said feebly, as if he had any other choice. Stanley headed down the mountain. The sleep and the onions had done him a lot of good as well. He felt strong. It was fairly easy to follow the trail he had made 2 days earlier. There were a few places where he wasn't sure he was going the right way, but it just took a little bit of searching before he found the trail again. He went quite a ways down the mountain, but still didn't find the shovel. He looked back up toward the top of the mountain. He must have walked right past it, he thought. There was no way he could have carried Zero all the way up from here. Still, he headed downward just in case. He came to a bare spot between two large patches of weeds and sat down to rest. Now, he had definitely gone too far, he decided. He was tired out from walking down the hill. It would have been impossible to have carried Zero up the hill from here, especially after walking all day with no food or water. The shovel must be buried in some weeds. Before starting back up, he took one last look around in all directions. He saw large indentation in weeds in a little farther down the mountain. It didn't seem likely that the shovel could be there, but he already come this far. There lying some tall weeds, he found the shovel and the sack of jars. He was amazed. He wondered if the shovel and the sack might have rolled down the hill, but none of the jars were broken except the one which had broken earlier. And if they had rolled down the hill, it was doubtful that he would have found the sack of the shovel side by side. On the way back up the mountain, Stanley had to sit down and rest several times. It was a long, hard climb.